Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making elephant ears. And this is a sweet, munchy treat that you might like for watching the Super Bowl or some other sporting event or maybe watching a movie. We're going to be mixing together a few items and taking them to the stove. And then we'll be putting some yeast in this, so we'll have to suspend our activity for a while, but the first thing to do is take 3/4 cup of milk and put it in a small saucepan. To that, you're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1 tablespoon of sugar, and then I have shortening, which is Crisco, and this is 1 1/2 ounces. So I'm just going to combine those and go to the stove, and I'll be stirring until my shortening melts and the sugar dissolves. And then we'll let it cool to 110 degrees before we continue. I have my temperature probe in the mixture that I've been cooling, and you can see that it just went from 110 to 109. So now we're ready to add our yeast. This is 1 packet of active dry yeast, and that is 0.75 ounces. So stir that in, then all we need to do is let this sit until it's bubbly, and then we'll continue our recipe. I've let my yeast mixture sit for 10-15 minutes, and you can see it's nice and foamy. That's what it should look like. And then you're going to add it to a bowl where you have 2 cups of all-purpose flour. So I'm going to work that in. I'll stir a little bit, and then if I have to use my hands, I will. But I need to make a dough of it, and it should come to a ball. I used my hands for the last little bit to get this into a nice ball. When you have it in a ball like this, then move to a floured surface, which I'm using my countertop. And I put some all-purpose flour out here. And what you're going to do is knead this. Just knead until it's nice and smooth. So just turn it over and rotate and keep folding and turning. And do that a few times. After your dough is nice and smooth like this, just cover it with some plastic wrap or something like that and let it sit for about 30 minutes to rise. My dough has been rising for 30 minutes, so I'm going to take off this covering and place this on a cutting board, and I'm going to just press it out a little bit so it's in a nice circle. I'm going to cut straight across so that I have 2 halves. And then if I take one of those halves and cut it in half, that would give us 1/4. So if I cut this in half, each of those, then this size of triangle would give me 8 of these altogether. Your goal is to get this as thin as would be reasonably possible, and you want it to be even, and you want it to be fairly circular. So that's fine. Actually, it's a little oblong. Might work on it in this direction a little bit. So I'm just going to set that over on a platter and continue to do that. And from my plans here, I'll have 8. Altogether of that size. I'm just finishing up my 8th circle, and most of these are oblongs actually. It doesn't really matter. These are elephant ears, and I think probably they are more true to life if they're oblong than if they are circular, but you just want to get something that's really flat like that. So I'm putting that on my platter. These will not stick together if you have enough flour on them. Now over here at the stove, I have an iron skillet with about 1 inch of peanut oil. And I've been heating this, and I have a thermometer probe in it. I can't see it right now. but Rick is holding it up and it says 273. I'm going to have to wait until this gets to 375 and we'll fry these one at a time. And then we're going to have a dusting of confectioner sugar, so I'll get ready for that. My thermometer is reading 372, so in no time it'll be 370. It's 374, so it's time to go ahead and put the first one of these in. It's nice to use tongs because that way you won't burn yourself. And you can see it takes up quite a space. So just plan on doing one at a time and they'll puff up like that. That's the nice thing about them. And they take just a small amount of time per side. And I will use my tongs to grab it and turn it over when it needs it. I'll take a look underneath. And it's light golden brown. I expect it to be a little browner than that. So we'll give it as much as a minute, maybe. We can probably go ahead and turn it. I want you to see this completed one. So I'll just grab it, bring it over, and you can see the same thing is going to happen on the opposite side. When it's so thin like that, it will cook through very quickly. But it still looks a little doughy in the middle. So we're going to wait for it to get completely done. Just check the underside. We don't want it burned. I am going to turn this off right now because I'm going to finish this one completely and then come back and do the rest of them to complete out our plate. That's browned up nicely, but it still seems a little doughy in the center. So I turned it back over, but just a few seconds and I think it'll be great. So we're going to move it on to a paper towel that I have lining this roasting pan and try to get it drained as well as we can. And while it's still hot, what we want to do is take some confectioner sugar and just sprinkle it over the top. Oops, excuse me. And then turn it over and get the other side. If it's hot, it will have a little bit of that grease still there and it will stick and that will make it nice. So that's what our elephant ear looks like, and we'll have 8 of them in our serving platter. Here's our finished dish of elephant ears, and they look dramatic and they're so easy to make. And you could make a double batch if you wanted to. You could make these half as big if you wanted twice as many servings. But it would be a really nice sweet treat for your Super Bowl party, or if you have people over for Grammys or Oscars or whatever, that's nice. Or if you just want to make them for yourself, they're always good. So I'm going to take one on my plate. Let's see, I like the crispest ones that could possibly be there. And this one's still warm. They're all pretty warm because we just finished the frying of them and I got the last one out, got it drained and dusted with confectioner sugar. So I'm going to put this in my plate along with my very small glass of iced tea. And I'm just going to tear off the end here and take a bite of this crusty part. That tastes so good. This would be my downfall if I let it be, because I just don't allow myself to have donuts. And this has that flavor a little bit. I figure donuts being such a favorite of mine, if I ate them as much as I wanted, then I would be very large. So to keep that from happening, I just take an occasional taste like this. It's nice and crispy, sweet. The air bubbles in it just adds to the crunchiness. It's really a wonderful treat. And if you've not tried it, it's fun to make. I really enjoyed making these. I don't do a lot of deep frying, but I plan to make for the next video, I plan to do a really easy version of elephant ears. And then I plan to do some deep frying right after that, or pretty soon after that. And this oil, as long as you don't let it smoke, it's going to be good. But you start with something that is not going to affect it very much, like elephant ears, a couple of varieties. And then if you do fish or something like that, After that, it's time to just go to new peanut oil. I refrigerate the peanut oil in between uses, but I will use it 2, 3, 4 times depending on what has been in it. So I hope you enjoy this video, and I hope you enjoy the idea of elephant ears, and maybe you'll try it for one of your get-togethers or at home party.